Hello children, hope you all are well. So in the previous topics I have sent you already through PDF file, chapter 1 and 3, which has been already done in the school before the examination, final examination of the other classes. Now today I am going to deliver you a small lecture of the chapter 4, reproductive health. So go through the video, and if you have any doubt regarding the topic, then kindly text me or you can mail me in the given under below email ID. So today we are going to learn about reproductive health. This is a chapter 4 biology portion. Now what do you mean by reproductive health? Reproductive health means the total well-being in all aspects of reproduction, that is physical, emotional, behavioral and social aspects of a person. It means reproductive health. Now then we are going to study about the problems and strategies of reproductive health. What are the problems related to reproductive health? The first is there is very little knowledge about personal hygiene and personal health by various parts, various people in our country. And this little knowledge about personal hygiene and health may lead to the various type of diseases in the reproductive organ, like STDs, that is sexually transmitted diseases. Next point is early marriages. Now in India, in many states, you know, people are illiterate or they do not know what are the impacts of early marriages. So early marriages are very high. So that lead to maternal and infant mortality rate. That is also a very severe issue. Third is lack of awareness that lead to increase in the population size among the people. And fourth is myths and taboos and misconceptions about sex related issues. So these are the problems of reproductive health. So you see, you will now learn about the strategies of reproductive health. Now see, in 1951, after independence, the government of India started family planning program. Now this family planning program was started to cuttle down population, that is the growing population should be restricted. That was a plan of the government of India. So population control was done by this program. By like there was various type of aspects. Now next is RCH program. Now what is RCH? Reproductive and Child Health Care Program. This was launched in 1997 by Indian government. Okay, now why this was launched? It has 2 points. Okay, now the first point is to create awareness among people about various reproductive related issues. Okay, and the second is to provide facilities and supports for building the reproductively healthy society. So these are the 2 main mottos of RCH program. The third point is audiovisual aids and print media were created. So they've actually created awareness among the people. Okay, now comes the proper information. So proper information about reproductive organs were given to the people. Okay, so how it was done? It was done by encouraging sex education in schools to give the right information about the reproductive organs to the young minds and save them from different type of misconceptions and taboos. Okay, next come the educating people about different type of like birth control options. Okay, so educating people about birth control options, like for pregnant mother, there were various type of programs initiated, prenatal care, okay, care of the mother, care of the child, and importance of breastfeeding. All these were planned in this program. And next come the sex related abuse and crimes. Okay, these were cuttled down. How? Now awareness of the problem due to uncontrolled population growth was also like social evils were there at that time. Still now there are so many social evils. So these were cuttled down. And last is total ban on fetal sex determination. So you know there is a term called amniocentesis. This is about banning of fetal sex determination. So these are the strategies of reproductive health. Okay, now next topic is population explosion. Now what do you mean by explosion? Explosion means sudden increase. So why the population in India has suddenly increased? Now not only in India but in the entire world, there is an explosion of population. Now this is, what is the definition for this? Tremendous increase in the size and growth of population. It's called population explosion. Now see, there is a data given here about the population size in the world. In 1900, it was only 2 billion. While you see here in 2000 AD, it was 6 billion. There is a sharp rise of 4 billion people in the world. Now let us discuss about population size in India. In India, at the time of independence, it was only 350 million. While in May 2000, it was over 1 million. And the recent one, that is of 2017 census, it is about 1.34 billion. So here you can see how rapidly the population is increasing. Okay. Now, why is this population increasing? What is the cause of the increase in the population? Now, see, there are a few causes that I have written here. First cause is rapid decline in that MMR. MMR means maternal mortality rate. So the mothers, those who were giving birth to the young ones, children, they used to die in the previous time. Okay. So why? Because there was no such medical facilities. But now see, maternal mortality rate has declined. So mothers are not dying, okay, while giving birth to children. So there is a good aspect though. Second one is rapid decline in the death rate of people, mean general death rate of various diseases. So rapid decline was there at that time, but now rapid increase was there, but now there is a decline in the death rate. Okay. Third is decline in the IMR. IMR means infant mortality rate. So infants, there was no vaccination, there was no proper treatment at that time. So people used to die. Okay, the children used to die because of various type of ailments. So there is a decline in IMR, and there is a sharp increase in the number of age group of people, those who are in the age of reproductive, okay, period. That means the people, those who are in the age group of reproductive phase, their number is increased in India. So young people are more in India. So these are the four reasons why India has a sharp increase in population. The next topic is birth control. So see, how can we control birth? So we have to take some steps to curb the population increase. So why? What we can do? We can do two things. Okay, it is not written here. Just listen to me. First is by raising the marriageable age group of the girls to 18 years and boys to 21 years. And second is given incentives are given to the people, those whose family size is less. So like those who are having only a single girl child, by central government there are various schemes which are there, by which they are getting incentives. Okay. So these are the ways how can we curb population growth. And next come, how can we control birth? That is by contraceptive methods. Now what is contraceptive method? The contraceptive methods are various type of methods that are used, okay, to motivate people to have small family sizes. So these are there are some of the criteria which can we can consider for an ideal contraceptive. So how can we tell that some contraceptives are ideal? For that we will learn some points. The first point is user friendly. The contraceptive should be user friendly. That is, the person who is using it should be friendly with him. Means he can easily use it. Second is easily available. Okay, easily accessible. Third is effective and reversible. That is, it should be effective for contraception and reversible. And fourth is non-interfering with the sexual desire of the person. That means the normal biological process of having sex should not be interfering because of this contraceptive. Okay, so these are the ideal contraceptives. So children, today I have discussed about the problems and strategies of reproductive health. Okay, so the next day I will be teaching you about the various type of contraceptive devices and various type of contraceptive methods that are applied to curb population or to control population. So if you have any doubt regarding this topic till that I have taught today, you can text in the group or you can call me in my contact number 9932996692, that I will be giving you the end part of the video, or you can mail me in my email ID. Okay.